It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1585, recorded Thursday, August 25th, 2016. Watch that watch! On this episode of the Giz Wiz, Dick has two gadgets to recharge your phone. It is the last of Smart Home Month, so I got two gadgets to throw your way. And then don't forget about the warehouse. All coming up next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now! And here he is, the master of gadgets, the gadget guru, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing good, sir. I like your shirt.
Scam school. Scam school.
Yes.
Yeah. I worked for the guy who runs Scam School, Brian Brushwood. I worked for him for a year and a half. Many people don't know this. There's a guy, yeah, Brian Brushwood, worked for him.
I remember you, the only person I know who ever carried around a bed of nails.
Yes, and those are dangerous, actually, very dangerous. You have to be very careful when transporting beds of nails.
When you do that, what do you put, like a foam rubber mattress over it?
No, it would break apart kind of like two pieces of a puzzle. And so you kind of had like a little lip on one side. So so you could pick one up, turn it upside down, and then drop the nails on each other. And it would, you know, both nails would not, you know, you. But there was so much procedure. That was probably the most, I don't know, OSHA compliant, gimmick that we ever did. I had specific areas I had to step in order to help up and down Brian, who is the magician. I had specific things that I would have to tell the guests as they were coming up, and it was a procedure. The bed of nails. Yeah, that was
Oh yeah, that's interesting. Because at the reason we talked about it a long time ago is at Toy Fair they had a bed of nails,
mm-hmm.
And I said to the guy, you know, can I lay on it? And I remember him saying, okay, but you have to do this. Now you have to do that.
Yeah.
You have to do that. Now don't put your hand there. So yeah. I guess there's a lot of liability that you have to.
There
worry
is.
About.
I mean, because if you think about it, I mean, a bed of nails isn't too crazy to anyone nowadays. We all kind of understand that. If you distribute your weight on something, any one thing isn't going to hurt you. But if you screw up and misstep or lose your balance and put your hand down and you don't use the entire surface of the nail, basically the edge of the bed of nails was like danger zone, because if you're not distributing your weight on the entire bed of nails, then you're going to have a problem. So that was why... We are so scared of the bed of nails. Don't screw up that trick. Yeah.
And that's why we decided not to have a bed of nails
on this show. It would just
at the meetup. There'll be no bed of nails.
Sorry, we had to nix it. You know, the carnival company wanted to bring it, but we had to say no. No.
Both Basin Cafe said no.
They said no. We don't have the insurance for this bed of nails here.
Exactly.
So yeah. This is what I have to show for all the work I did with Brian Brushwood. It was this T-shirt. I saw it, I got a T-shirt. I probably had the most interesting lines of work, because sometimes I feel like I don't even believe myself. Someone will be talking about, so, oh, I'm installing a television. Oh, well, I used to work at a company that installed televisions. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Well, I went to go see a show. Oh, yeah. I used to work for a magician and traveled the country as a magician. Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, this technology, I was a technology reporter at one point.
Well, you know, that's very funny, because when I meet somebody And over a period of a half hour, I go, oh, yeah, well, I wrote the match game for 30
yeah,
years.
Exactly.
Oh, no, I write for Mad Magazine. I've been in every issue for 50 years. Oh, yeah, I worked on. I worked with Soupy Sales. We did Hell's a Poppin' up in Montreal.
Yeah.
And now I'm thinking, people go home and go, I met this crazy man.
This guy who has delusions.
This guy who thinks he was, like, working all these places.
Absolutely. I did Balloon Animals. Yeah. Paul's even saying, like... I worked in a warehouse, like an Amazon-style warehouse. I worked basically in construction. I wasn't actually nailing 2x4s together, but I was digging trenches and running wires, basically low-level electrician work at one point. I mean, I agree. I feel like after I leave some parties, you know, I'm like, they must have thought that I was just
trying
to impress them, and you know, that's not it at all. It's like,
that's very funny. That's very funny.
Has anything good been going on this last week?
Oh, Dennis and I celebrated our 4th anniversary.
Oh, that's wonderful.
So we went to a little French restaurant. Joe Bolanos treated us to that, and then Lindy Dunn, who was a witness at our wedding, was there, and it was fun.
And
people are so kind. 300 people, you know, posted congratulations on social media. That's one of the amazing things about social media is that as soon as you tell people that you did something, and actually it's a great thing I do like about Facebook. I do like those 1 year ago today things because I was thinking, oh, tomorrow's our anniversary. I hope I have a picture I could put up or something. And then the next morning, Dennis and I in front of a fake picture of City Hall saying, did you know that 4 years ago on today you got married? And I go, yeah, let me just post that right now.
That's so, very convenient, Facebook. Thank you.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Here,
and you?
I actually have the photo right there.
There you go.
There you go. That's fantastic. Wow.
And you, what did you do this week?
God, what did I do this week? I've been, you know, when you move into a new place, especially a new house, there's all this incredible amount of things that I just didn't think that I needed to do. Like, I have a fence now, and the fence hasn't been stained, and you gotta stain your fence, otherwise... it's gonna weather over time, and you'll have to replace the fence earlier. So I went out there and I started to paint the fence like I've been told I need to do. I get about 6 feet in and realize it's 100 degrees in Texas, and why am I doing this? So now I have about 6 feet of fence painted. It looks quite silly, and I need to either wake up early enough that the weather isn't so bad, or I need to paint the fence at night or something, get over the heat. So I painted 6 feet of fence last week.
Okay.
Luckily, I was smart enough to do what faces into the house. You know.
Oh yeah, that's
towards the street, towards the house. So I did towards the house. So only I have to look at the 6 feet of. It's not even paint, actually. It's I've stained it a color. but that's and then just work. You know, normal. Normal stuff. Rent a sprayer, says PC Guy. I definitely felt like that. That I need A, hire a professional, or B, get a sprayer or something.
Because
I'm over there, you know, painting what's that book where he has to whitewash the fence?
Tom Sawyer.
Tom Sawyer, right. I feel like Sawyer.
Yeah.
I'm like, hey, you know, can I get someone else to do this for me? That'd be great. Definitely. That's, I mean, really, I haven't done much this summer, summer's ending, and it's just been actually kind of nice to stay at the house and just continue. I've been brainstorming, been writing up, like little scripts for myself and, trying to really focus on work and that sort of stuff. And so, yeah, that's basically all I've been doing.
Okay. Very good.
Yeah.
Very good.
Let's jump into some gadgets.
Okay, we're going to jump into some gadgets. And the first one is from a company called Night Eyes that does some fun stuff. And it's a preview look at this.
Dun, 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 dun.
DeBartolo, man's maddest writer in the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Coming upstairs.
We keep a lot of stuff in the cellar. Okay? We like lanterns. We like LEDs. We like stuff from Night Eyes. And this is one of their newest. It was just introduced at the Outdoor Products Show. I'm going to turn the light on here. Night Eyes, they're very clever. And one of the clever things is the carry bag. They made the carry bag translucent so it can diffuse the light. If you want to walk with a diffused light or hang it in the tent and have a diffused light. So why not have a carry bag that does two purposes? And so we're going to unsheathe the, it is the Radiant 300 lamp. Okay, now this guy, it's only 300 lumens, but for some reason it looks really, really bright. So it has three brightnesses, that's all the way full, and that's off. So that's full, medium, low, and then off. But then if you need a red light, instead of clipping, pushing the button on, hold the button in. Hold the button in, and it lights up red.
Interesting.
Now if you're a boater or a pilot, you know that white lights are blinding. So if you want to look at a chart, at least I know for the boat, I assume pilots are the same. When you look at a chart at night in a boat, you look at it using a red light because it doesn't give you night blindness.
You can still screw up your night vision, basically.
Yes.
But it doesn't affect your vision so much. So that is a fourth way to light this guy. And then it just goes off. It has a carabiner clip at top, so you can hang it on to whatever you're walking with. Actually, you can clip it onto a belt if you want. It's very light. I think it's like 10 ounces or so. And it's a rechargeable battery, so you don't have to worry about running out of juice. And on the side, it tells you how many hours it runs. So at 300 lumens, 5 hours at full. 75 lumens, 20 hours. And at 15 lumens, 110 hours. But wait, there's more! Okay? It has a 2600 milliamp rechargeable battery in here. And consequently, ta-da! Consequently, it has USB out.
Nice!
So USB in to charge it, USB out, so you can also recharge your phone if you want to. This is just coming on the market now. It is called the Radiant 300 Rechargeable Lantern. And we're taping this August 23rd. And it says out of stock on the Night Eyes website. But it's you can go over there at the Night Eyes website. It's out of stock mainly because they haven't started shipping them yet. So there you are. Night Eyes is spelled N-I-T-E. I-Z-E, so the nighteyes.com, and once they're in stores, they'll appear on Amazon. But this is a first look. Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater, here at gizwiz.tv. Bye!
Captain J.
On to hide my wrinkles.
You gotta diffuse, you gotta use a diffuser on the
yes.
light. Captain Jay points out that would be perfect at for painting at night.
There you go. There you go. You have no excuse.
No excuse. Not with Night Eyes. It's great. So does all of Night Eyes, with a company name like Night Eyes, you would think that all of their products have that red functionality built in so that you don't lose your night vision.
No, you know what? It's a group of guys who are avid outdoor people.
Okay.
And so they make every kind of keychain and every kind of one of my favorite things is called the doohickey.
Yes, I have heard of the
remember
doohickey.
Remember that?
Yes,
right. It looks like a key, but it's a wrench and a pliers and a bottle opener. They just make tons of neat stuff. And that's going to, I know it's $45. But once it gets into stores and stuff, they usually discount the stuff on Amazon.
Right.
But nice, it's a fun website to roam through.
Oh, I didn't know they made a cell phone holder. They make all sorts of stuff. They must only do lights. No. Duh.
They make headlights. They make dog lights. They just do great stuff. Fun stuff.
Wow. Nice gadgets. Okay, Night Eyes. That is the Night Eyes lantern that will also recharge your phone. That did look quite bright. I never know if lumens or watts or what is a good way to measure light level output. LUTs, I've heard,
LUX.
Candle light. Candles, foot candles. You know, I've heard of so many different ways to measure light.
Right. But when you turn it on, it looks bright. So I go, well, this is good.
Right.
This is good. Yeah.
It's yeah. Bright. Also, that's what they need to put on the box. It's bright. There you go.
Very bright.
Sell me whatever you want now.
the way they built the reflector in there, it amplifies the light. Whatever they did, I think it looked good.
Yes. Absolutely. Absolutely. Cool. Let's move on to the next gadget.
Okay. Our next thing is two gadgets. If you travel, this is a great combination gadget. So let's take a peek at that.
Here we go.
Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv. You know, at GizWiz.tv, we try to find unusual gadgets or a usual gadget that can do something different, like this external phone charger that is also a juicing machine.
Wow.
But we're going to ask our cameraman why this phone charger comes with this thing.
Any guess, Chad?
I've unfortunately read the show notes. I know.
Oh, okay.
On your belt. Okay, that's not a bad guess. Actually, it's even better than that, because this guy is called AirScale. Okay, so this gives you two items you definitely want when you travel, and it gives it to you in one device. So it is, I'm going to click the little button here. All right, so that actually is the scale, 00, and the lower thing, 100%, means this is AirScale. Is fully charged. So how does it work? Okay. So this little clip, it's very clever. This little clip hooks onto that. And we're going to walk over here. Oh, we didn't think about lighting this, but you know what? Can you see that suitcase there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's see. We didn't rehearse this because having a suitcase might have given away the hint that it was a scale. So now I'm going to pull it up and then I have to click it over to scale. And now I'm going to lift it and
point it to the camera.
Come up to the top. This weighs
96 pounds. Whoa. 9.6.
Oh, there you go. 9.6.
Yeah. And the funny is, either way, it's 9.6.
Exactly right.
When you, before you head to the airport.
Very clever.
You know, just check what the maximum a suitcase can weigh with your airline. It does tend to vary if you're going domestic or overseas. And then you can weigh it with your little air scale. And it is also I'm going to check the box here. Ta-da! 6,500 milliamp built-in battery. So that's good, too. So here you have the input. Comes with a little cable. That's to charge it. That's the output. So assuming this is fully charged, that should probably charge your phone one and a half to two times. And it comes with a little carry bag. And I like the fact that the way they designed it is it makes it really nice to hold it as a scale. So you have phone charger, scale, you get the little belt, not belt thing. Now I'm saying belt. You get this little cable here to weigh your suitcase. And as I said, that clips back in there. It's very clever how it does that.
And it is, let's go to the magic board. It is $59 suggested retail price. AirScale power bank with digital scale. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. And by the way, the maximum weight for this is 88 pounds or 40 kilos. Bye.
Wow. Okay. So, you know, what's funny is I actually travel with a scale all the time. And I have mine right here.
So this is my goodness.
This is a normal, you know, this is a mono-use scale. You don't got anything fancy in here. And all it does is power. And you can change the units if you want it to be pounds or kilos. And it works exactly the same. I have a little thing here. You use that same sort of clip thing and hold it, and can see that this weighs 3.9 kilograms. What is it in pounds? 8.6 pounds. So.
Wow, our suitcase is empty. Almost weigh the same.
I know, right? There you go. So that's pretty neat, because you're going to travel with a power bank, and
exactly.
It's great to have a scale with you wherever you are. Now, do you think the price is a little high? I feel like
I'm wondering if when it gets into distribution, if it wouldn't drop a bit.
It goes down a bit.
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
I agree.
I mean, it's very well designed, but I agree that it seems to be up there in price.
Yeah. I would be happy paying maybe $30, about half price. I think off the top of my head, you know, no market research. Currently it's at $59 and available on Amazon, and then also on their website as well.
Yes, right. So. And how many people reviewed it? So it's kind of
On
new-ish.
Amazon, it was 11 people.
11, okay. Oh, okay.
And they're a few 4 stars, but mostly 5 stars. So it's 4.8 out of 5.
It is nicely built. I can attest to that.
And it feels good in the hand. It feels like solid.
Yeah, it's very solidly built. And also, when it's not lit, it looks like a block of black something. And then the numbers shine through. It's actually very well designed.
Oh, yeah, I see that. So it's hard to tell there's a screen until it actually turns on. And that's nice.
Exactly. And that
also,
little clip,
go ahead,
clip
sorry.
Thing. Oh, that's okay. Dennis has to run get this. Believe it or not. UPS has just arrived. I stayed home the entire day. And if Dennis doesn't run out and get this. Oh, you know what?
Do you need to get up?
I feel like
get on up there. I really wish I still had the this is where we wait. I don't know if I have that song. Oh, I'm so upset. We used to have a theme when I really wish that I still had the This Is Where We Wait song.
Yes, we need that.
I wish I had it. I would just search through my MP3s. I only have I don't have that jingle.
Oh, we have to get that. It's somewhere online. No, this is so typical, isn't it? We went to lunch today. I got a neighbor to stand by in case UPS came.
Yes.
And now it is 8:05. Okay. But at least it's here. It's
normally they also say it'll be delivered at least by 8 p.m., right?
Yes.
It's five minutes after.
Yes. Here in the city, it says up till 6:45.
Oh, my God.
So actually, it came at 5:05. But I got it. So that's the main thing.
Oh, man, I'm upset I don't have that MP3. I can't believe.
We'll have to get it by next week.
I know.
We start at 7:30. Normally, the bell does not ring.
Exactly. When the show was earlier, it was used all the time, you know.
You get
something in the mail and have to go grab it. But now that we move the show so late that it doesn't normally happen. Anyway, that was a funny interruption. So that was the AirScale, $59 even, either at AirScale on Amazon, or you can go to Shop.
Yeah, just go to gizwiz.biz and there's a link to it. I know.
I don't know how to say this. It's like
O-axis.
O-axis. It's like oats and axis. You know, came together. O-A-X-I-S .com is where you can find it.
Yes.
Well, this week we have something different because
yes, you thought that next week was also going to be cheap smart home gadgets.
No.
And you bought two, so
smart
I figured
things.
You already bought them.
I already got them.
Do them both.
Okay, here we go.
No, you don't need it, but you might want it at Chad's Crappy Corner. Get it.
Okay.
So, crappy gadget number one.
Crappy gadget number one is actually something that I saw on Amazon's Kickstart program. Have you heard of this?
No.
So basically Amazon saw what Kickstarter was doing. It's not called Kickstart. I believe that it's called Launchpad. Let me see what it's actually called. Let me load up this site here. Amazon Launchpad. So when people had a product, you could kind of do a social media push around pre-ordering, and Amazon would give them a little bit of a heads up, and the page also looks quite different. It's called the Flick, and this is their page. You can kind of see that it's not the typical Amazon page. It's kind of a little bit different.
And
they have a video, you know, a big video right here that's very similar to a Kickstarter video, and same thing when you click this, it's very similar to a Kickstarter video.
The thing is, you just buy it at a regular price.
You just
right?
buy it. Now, this is already a product. I can't tell. So it has this very clever video. Oh, was he laying down? Now he's standing up. I just bought it. It's like the product, is done, and I can just buy it whenever. So, it is called the Flick. And here is the entire product. It's almost difficult to see. Oh man, that is one bright bright camera. But this is it. You can see there's a little Flick logo down in there, embedded in the plastic. And the idea is that this is a universal button. There is a little bit of stickiness on the back, which you can attach anywhere you want. Let me turn down that brightness. And then you program it within an app. Now, the first issue that I had with the Flick is it comes to you in this nice little Flick box, the wireless smart button. Okay, it has thank you so much. Thank you, you're amazing. This is great. You've made this product a reality. You open it up, you get an extra little clip, which it kind of allows this to go onto your belt or your pants, so you could add this to the back of your Flick. And then you open it, and you get the Flick out of here, and then that's it. And I'll be real honest, as smart as I am, I didn't know what to do next. There's no instructions.
What?
There's no make sure you download our app on the App Store. There's no, I didn't know. I didn't do my research. I bought it and it came and I didn't know what to do. So luckily I'm smart enough that I went to the App Store, searched for Flick, and there's an app that looks very much like it should be the app. If I just go in here, And it's not spelled, you know, it's spelled a weird Flick. So I guess that works out. And so what's even weirder is that if you search for F-L-I-C, the only way that they spell their app, they're not the first app that shows up. They're the second app. So
that's weird. So someone else has...
A Flick, has a product called Flick. But how confusing to the user. Luckily, I was pretty sharp-eyed and could tell that the first app didn't really look like what I wanted, but that seems like a really bad move on their part, on their product design team, to have a product arrive at your house with zero instructions, and then also to not be savvy enough to be the first app on the top of the search list. I don't know how they could change that, but a big help would be if it said, make sure you download our app Flick with a icon of what they're
Yeah.
Like. Anyway, that was the first thing that I was pretty frustrated with. Next, now I went ahead and so you can do lots of different, you can add lots of different functionality to your Flick button, and I actually enjoyed this. With one click, I have it set up to I have it set to turn on and off, to toggle on and off a Wiimote switch, and all that does is turn the power on to all my lights and turn the power off to all my lights.
Okay.
On a double click, I have it set to find my phone. So if I double click, ooh, there we go. So that's it, finding my phone. Unlock the phone. Okay, it stopped.
So how many different things can one Flick do?
So it's easy to set up three very specific, unique, different things. There's a click, there's a double click, and then there is a hold. So if you click and hold. But what I found is that you can actually, so I have all three of these added, but you can add another thing. And I actually, so let's do find my phone again. Okay, I'm going to add this. So now I have two things connected to one click. I click it once. I guess it does both. Okay, so it does both. Okay, delete. Stop. I found my phone. Okay, there we go. So you can have like a range of things that will happen. So if I wanted to do an emergency SMS to some friends, but you can see all the different things that you can have. You can have set an alarm clock, do some Apple Music control, Chromecast, count the presses, send an emergency SMS. So this could basically be like one of those I've fallen and I can't get up type things. Hang up calls, you got a Harmony Hub, if this, then that. Lock screen things, Philips Hue, playing sound, opening Safari, sending emails, asking Siri stuff, stopwatches, timers, vibrate. I have Wemo. Yo, remember the app Yo? You could add a Yo in there. So there's actually a lot of features. And the fact that it works with if this then that means that, I mean, it can really do anything that IFTTT can do, which is pretty gosh darn amazing. So there's a lot of recipes or a lot of things that could do things in Flick. And I'm actually really surprised by that you could silence your phone or hang up a call or whatever. That's actually quite
Quite nice. But you have to, each one has to be started with a special kind of number of presses, right?
Or, well, really, you only have three different types of presses.
Oh, okay. But, you know, because I was watching the video, and the guy has these all over his house.
Right, exactly. So one click can really only do one thing per Flick. So you can't say, well, click it five times, and it does something else.
Oh.
Okay. You really only have click, double click, and click and hold.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, so you'd have to get extra Flicks to add extra clicks into your life.
Wow, you could sell them that.
I know. Oh, it's just a
the only thing is then, Chad, you would have to remember that if I do one click on my black one,
yes,
it does that. But yes, if I do one click on my green one,
right,
it does. Yeah, okay.
Right. Now there is, so I had set it up with my Wemo switch, and I actually really enjoyed it because no one likes to pull out your phone. If you're in an app, you hit the home button, you swipe over, find the right app, click that, then click the thing to turn on or off your lights, right? Wemo has an app. And so I've been using it with my Amazon Echo. So I say, I don't want to set off anyone's Echo, but you say your name and then I say, turn on my studio lights. And that's been working great. But it kind of feels almost a little pretentious at times, because if I'm showing people to the house, or if I'm in a Skype call or on stream and I'm sitting there and I say, I'm going to say Echo instead of her name, Echo, turn on my studio lights. And then the lights turn on. It's like, it almost feels a little bit like show-offy. Yeah. So yeah. I actually really enjoyed being able just to silently click a button without interrupting a conversation that I was in the middle of to turn on the lights or whatever, because the Echo was by far the best way to turn on the lights at that point. So I actually really liked that. Until today, when I wanted to show off the turn on and off light feature, so I moved my Wemo into this studio instead of my Twitch streaming studio, and it will not pair with the Wemo, which is understandable. I'm not really harping them on that. What I'm harping them on is there is zero way for me to remove the Wemo. It's connected to a device. So right now it's set to one click. It'll turn on, it'll toggle my Wemo switch. So if I click it, it makes a ding, and then it says the device is not responding. So I'm like, okay, well, this makes sense. So if I delete this, and then I go in, and then scroll back down, it still has my Wemo device in here, and I can't get it to, like, unlearn this device. I spent about, you saw me before the show, so normally you would click, you know, this is the Wemo device I want, and click add, and now it's back added. But if I go, I mean, seriously, you guys know me. If I go into settings, you should probably be able to turn it off in here. Can't find it there. Go into providers, which is the section of stuff. Wemo is right here. I can't unclick Wemo. You can see there's a green light on. You can't unclick it. I can search for more Wemo devices. It's still going to find my studio license. It's infuriating. I can't get it to unlearn the lights so that I can get it to work again.
Well, you're going to have to buy another one,
I guess. And at that, the price of these, I don't think there's any way for the user to remove the battery and re-add a new battery. And this is kind of becoming a norm, is for very compact devices, they're disposable. And when the battery dies, you go buy another one. Same thing with the...
How much is this?
$35, $34 to be exact. It costs $34 for this little button. And that's absurd. Like... it needs to cost $11. No market research was done to determine that price. But, like, I don't want to spend $34 for a button. And, anyway, so you can see, I actually thought that this was going to be kind of a really, really, really good device. But with the problems with the app, with the problems with the instructions, which is a hurdle you get over pretty quickly.
And no battery replacement.
And no battery replacement. Seems. And the price, I would say this is definitely in the crappy corner section of of the corner. And I almost didn't expect that. I thought that I'd be really happy with it. So that is the Flick. That's my first gadget. Now, the next gadget...
But wait, there's more!
So, and by the way, remember, we are in Smart Home Month, so that connects with all sorts of smart home devices and stuff.
It's Bluetooth?
It is Bluetooth, yes. Bluetooth.
Okay.
So the next device that I have is the RM Mini 3. Now, you may not know that, that brand name, and I don't think that really anyone will... this is from Broadlink, and this company does a very, very, very good job of making, and I'm going to sound very rude and maybe even, I don't know how this is going to sound. They do a very good job of making this look like an American company, but when you start reading the instructions, you get that weird translation issue with companies from across the seas. So, you know, there's like, here it's talking about the LED indicator right here. Waiting for configuration, device is under factory state or reset, and that was in parentheses, Under this circumstance, you can tap the add device in app, and it guides you to the finish to finish the configuration. So you can see that English isn't all that great, but luckily, basically the instructions and maybe a few weird wordings in the app was really the extent of where that kind of cultural barrier kind of fell apart. Because, weirdly, I actually like this app. So here, let me, before I get into the app, I guess I need to tell you, what does this do? Why would you buy this product? And it connects to your home Wi-Fi, and with the Wi-Fi connected, you can now control other IR devices with this little thing. It kind of looks like a Mac Pro, you know, from Apple, like a little mini version of a Mac Pro. And it plugs in with with USB, mini micro USB.
It has to be there's
powered.
No battery in it.
There's
it
no battery in it.
Okay.
It'll plugs up, but then this shoots out IR, and you know that's IR and RF. IR is basically the light at the front of a remote. That's what you're gonna work with. So anything that uses one of the remotes that has one of these little lights at the front of it, this will actually work with. And so there's lots of devices that do this. Audio, you know, audio things, light switches will do it. Televisions, of course, are the big one. And it will use Wi-Fi to connect to this, and then this will shoot out IR wherever it needs to go. So you can control IR devices when you are, I think it may even work when you're away from the house. I haven't tested that. It may actually go through their servers, so you could control it from anywhere in the world. So let's get into the app. First off, this is what it looks like. I'm going to try to make sure that the glare isn't too bad here. You have a sort of a side hamburger menu where you can add a device, backup, share, do some settings feedback, and see a demo. Then in the main control area, you have these scenes, which you can sort of set up if you wanted to. So if I wanted to do a few things at once, I could set up a scene and have it do all of those things. And then you have your devices, and you add them by clicking over here and then hitting add remote, add a scene, add a device, which would be something like this. And then see your device list, and I only have the one remote. So let's get back over here and get back over. I got it. Okay, good. That remote.
So,
good.
So a
back.
Scene would be turn on the TV, turn on the DVR.
Right.
Okay.
There we go.
And turn on the sound system.
Exactly. Or like, you know, set the lights, set these three lights off and set this one on and turn up the stereo, you know, that sort of thing. So let's get into, so I've set it up with the television remote right now already. So here's how this works. I'm going to go to the two shot, and then I'm going to hit we'll kind of switch back and forth. I'm going to hit the power button. So hit the power button. Oh, you've just turned off, Dick. I just turned off the TV. I'm going to hit the power button again.
Okay. And maybe I won't come back.
Maybe he's gone forever. And then the TV will turn back on. I have things like volume up and down, so I'm going to do the volume up here, and you can see, oh, there goes the volume.
Yep, okay.
It's going way up, actually. I don't want it to go that high up. Go back down, volume. It basically has all the features. Now, you may be wondering, if you've ever done something like this before, where it's basically a universal remote, there's a few different ways that a universal remote will go about this. Either it'll have all the codes to all the televisions somewhere in some database, and you hit this and you say, load up this television, and it knows all the codes. Well, this is actually a little bit simpler than that, and I kind of like it. So here's how this works. You'll barely notice that some of these, here, we'll go to numbers. you can see that the 1 and the 2 are slightly brighter than 3 through all the others. Do you barely see that?
Yeah, I can see that.
So I've already programmed 1 and 2, but I haven't programmed 3. So this is the first time I'm hitting the 3 button. So I'll click it, and it says, I am waiting. I need to learn what the 3 button does. So then you go over to your actual remote, and you point it at the device, and you hit 3. And then back over here, it's learned it, and that little thing went away. Whoop, come on, focus. So 3 has now been learned. So I'll do it again with 4, so you can see. I come over here, I hit 4, and then it learns 4, and it goes away. So that's how this learns. It can be very kind of finicky and a little bit ridiculous kind of in the beginning because you have so many different buttons. But
yeah.
once you've worked it all out, I can come over here, hit menu. Hopefully menu will pop up over here. Maybe not. I can hit mute. Mute is on. Mute is off. Over there in the corner, it's a little hard to see. You know, volume up, volume down. And so,
all the way,
Max. I've noticed that, actually. That's probably the one bug that I've seen, is that if I click volume up once, it goes up a lot. If I put volume down, it goes down by just 1 every single time. Now, you also get a little bit, you get a little bit of a delay. So anytime I click, didn't mean to do that, volume down, you'll see that it's like, I'm thinking about it. Every single time it'll do that. So that's a little bit of a pain in the butt, but not really that big of a deal. So this, of course, will work with a whole bunch of different devices. So you can have, this is RCS. I'm not exactly sure what that is, but a whole bunch of on-off switches. You could have an audio. So you get play, pause, up, down. You get a nice little remote here. And then you can, of course, add all sorts of other remotes. Here's the various versions. Aircon, which is air conditioning. Audio, set-top box, TV, user-defined gesture control, user-defined action, and RCS. And then this one, which I can't click in it. It looks a little glitched down there. I'm not exactly sure what that one is. There is a lot of configurability. So if this television thing, I can click and hold, and I could delete. Or I could go into the TV and I can change all sorts of stuff. So I could do the template info. I could change the icon if I wanted to take a picture or choose one for my album. I can change the name. I can even do that in these sort of user-defined. I changed this user-defined to be my aspect ratio. So I could change that. I could learn a signal, learn a combo. There's all sort. This is actually very configurable. And I was actually pretty impressed. I was pretty gosh darn impressed with the RM Mini 3.
What does this cost?
So, the RM Mini 3 is available on Amazon, and it cost approximately $26. $26 for the Aircon, or for the Aircon, for the RM Mini 3. Now, you can see that it has sort of a different name here. I purchased this one. You know, on August 16th, this is the Broadlink Blackbean Smart Home Wi-Fi Remote IR Controller. So, it's kind of weird in its programming. And so it'll has these really weird images of like normal air conditioning temperature. You know, this is your comfort level. This is what the air conditioning is doing. But with this, so you can schedule times for it to turn the AC up or down.
Oh,
if your AC has it. Yeah, so it's very configurable and pretty interesting. I gotta say, I'm quite amazed with all of the top ranking electronic components. Stabilized Wi-Fi chip. Make sure all connection.
Well, the people who bought it loved it.
Yeah, people, so that's the thing, is that on Amazon, there's 13 customer reviews. People love this thing. And I gotta say, this is probably one of the best devices that seems to, you know, to be kind of in that weird area of you know, the Asian market trying to build something for the U.S. market, where they really did it well. And the app seems to be not buggy, seems to be user interface is pretty good. The construction even of this, it may feel a little bit light, but still I'm not worried that it's gonna like fall apart, you know what I mean? It comes with a nice cable to plug it up, and the packaging is nice too. So anyway, I gotta say, this works really well. It is very user definable, and the app is quite nice. So I would give this almost, it's kind of out of the crappy corner into not so crappy corner okay. area, other than, you know, you saw some of the instructions were.
Yeah, that's okay.
Were not so great. But yeah, so that is, now, and then there's also a lot of other devices that are very similar to this device still on Amazon. So this is the exact same thing, sold a little bit differently. You know, you got this one. God, this one only has one star. This is a $24, you know, a dollar one. This is not so good of reviews. In fact, I kind of want to see what is.
Oh my word!
Not detailed instruction. Not connected to the brand new Wi-Fi AP access point, which supports IEEE AC. Smartphone app is neither stable nor user-friendly. So, some people are having some issues with it. But yeah, so that is my experience with the RM Mini 3, and you can find a link in our show notes to the version that I bought on Amazon, so you don't buy the other versions. Hopefully that'll be in there. So yeah, that is that, and that wraps up this month's crappy corner theme of the smart home connected devices. Look for the next straw poll on Patreon very, very soon. Patreon.com/GizWiz is where you can support. All of our supporters get early access to vote on what the next month's theme will be. So please head on over there and support just a little bit. You don't got to support a whole bunch, just a little bit. That's all we're asking for. And we'd really appreciate it. And also you get to vote and change the direction that the Giz Wiz is headed in. So thank you so, so, so much. With that, let's move on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn.
And our letter is from Steve Maine. And it's a new gadget that may end up in a gadget warehouse once you see it. You'll have to decide. Hey, D&C. I guess that's Stick and Chad. You may remember me from gadget videos such as the kitchen nightlight and the Thing Charger review.
The Thing Charger review.
Well, today I have something special. It's not Bluetooth. I received a great gift during a door raffle. Huh. At a coach's appreciation night. And of course, I thought of you guys when I picked the prize from the table.
Oh, nice. Thank you.
I'm trying to keep a straight face in the video, and I managed to keep composed on my first use of this device. I hope you enjoy it. Okay. Khalib Maine. I believe Khalib Maine shot the video, and Steve is on camera. So let's look at this weirdish device.
Hey guys, figured I'd show you my brand new hot dog toaster. So appreciation night for some coaches that get your names dropped for some door prizes, and I won this beauty. This is by President's Choice. It will cook two hot dogs and two hot dog buns and toast them at the same time. So I figured I'd show you guys how it works. So I'm gonna take two hot dogs, and I'm gonna take them and put them in the tray at the top.
Is that sanitary?
I'm gonna take two hot dog buns, take them, and you set them in the side. Come on over here and look at this. I take them, and put it in the top, and this is just like a regular toaster. So I'm gonna go down on the side, press it down,
then jam the buns down.
And then squish the buns now, the rest of the way in. Cook. Oh.
Comes with these.
But this is the bizarre thing. They give you.
Oh, thanks for the tongs, and, guys.
Well, I know. You think they would insulate them.
So we have a toastiness level on the front. You can go all the way from 1 to 5 in case you don't like your hot dogs cooked.
It doesn't go to 6.
You also have the cancel button to eject them out early in case you're really hungry and you have to eat your hot dogs out really quick. But tongs are for when it's hot. You can lift the basket out and take the hot dogs out. So we'll show you in a minute how it goes. So our hot dogs and buns popped. It was a little bit hard to actually get them out. When it popped, they didn't come up all the way. I actually had to force them up. But now we have 2 toasted buns. These ones are a little, they are actually toasted, nice and toasted.
Nice and burnt.
These are a little bit stuck in here. So unplug it.
Yes, come on down.
Please unplug it. He did.
Okay, good. Yes.
There we go. So we have another toasted bun, nice and toasty. And we use this to take out the hot dogs.
Now, bun to hot dog, you think hot dogs and buns toast at the same level?
Voila.
Same time?
I don't know.
Hot dogs from toaster. Hope you guys like it.
It's certainly unique. Thank you for choosing that gadget and then showing it to us.
Yes. Well, you're right. I have no idea. I know that in a microwave you can make a frankfurter like in under a minute.
Yeah.
But I don't know about the toaster, and it is kind of weird. I mean, Steve was smart enough to unplug the toaster, but it's a little weird that they give you steel tongs to stick in the toaster.
Yeah.
And they're not insulated in any way.
And I think that it was his version was the president's choice.
The president's choice.
Obama's choice, basically.
Yes, yeah, right. Well, I have an idea. He's in Canada. So my guess is, is it president's choice is the brand,
right?
I don't
know. I found some random. There's okay, so if you go back and just search for hot dog toaster on Amazon. Here, I'm trying to go
okay.
back here. There's tons. There's tons of these things. You got... They're all red. This one's by Coca-Cola, right here. You got many options for your hot dog. This one, obviously, you need a Snoopy dog hot dog toaster.
But
duh.
You know what? All the controls of those first ones look the same. I think they're all just rebranded.
Exactly. Oh, exactly.
This looks exactly like the one Steve had. So they're only $20. Is that top one $20?
I hope you didn't spend too much on the... raffle, 15.
Oh, my God, 15, $16. Oh, my word. Yeah, this is one of those gadgets that I think is going to be warehouse ready in probably 3 months.
Yeah.
Hey, honey, how many times have we used that thing?
How often do you have to eat hot dogs for that to be useful to you?
And like, also, if the hot dogs run and the grease runs down into the toaster, yeah.
Good gadget. Very right. good gadget, Steve.
As someone in the chat room says, that is a shocking gadget.
I am electrocuted with electricity after a while. Wow. Okay.
Anyway, Steve and Caleb, thank you. It's very funny. It's a gadget that belongs on the Gizlet.
Yes, absolutely.
We like weird stuff and you found it.
If you have a gadget, make sure you send it in.
Yes, we're out of gadget videos. I believe that was the last one I think we have. So we need more gadget videos, like in the next week, okay? So a gadget that you have around the house, we especially love old gadgets. You know, we just know from videos past, people have gadgets that don't work or are outdated, but they can't throw them out. So make a little 2-minute video, 2 to 3 minutes, put it on YouTube as unlisted, send us the link and just a little email where you got it. And if you remember what you paid for it and send it to mail@gizwiz.tv. And if we show it on the show, like Steve and Caleb will get a copy of the current issue of Mad Magazine and one of those 30-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures.
and fame and fortune, fame and zero fortune, by having your video shown here on the Giz Wiz. But like I said, we need videos soon.
Maybe we'll even ship you a hot dog, courtesy of Steve. You know, nice and toasted.
Toasty.
I meant to mention that toast, that hot dog, it looked toasted really only on one end. On the edge. Absolutely. Okay, let's jump into the letter.
And we have two letters because they're both about the same gadget.
Uh-oh. I'm scared.
We are talking about the smart watch.
Don't tell me. I love my smart watch.
All right. Well, you lucked in because you paid a premium price.
Oh, did I?
Okay. All right. Letter number one from Alexis Perez. Hi, guys from Puerto Rico. I saw this article about the cheap smartwatch from episode 1580.
Right.
Oh, Chad, you should pay attention.
Okay, I am.
It seems that there is a back door that tries to communicate with a random IP in China once you use the pairing app. Since I have not received the watch, when I read this article, I asked Amazon for a refund based on the fact that the seller was not shipping on time. I did receive the watch, and I'm just going to use it as a dumb watch because it looks cool, or I may pair it with an old phone I previously erased just to see how it works. And then there's the link that says a group of resellers.
I spent $16 on my watch.
Okay, so it's possible.
I'm at risk. Oh, gosh.
But wait, there's more. Okay.
Oh, no.
Yes, here's another letter. Now, I don't even remember, Chad. We were talking about how cheap that was, and then the chat room found it for $7.
Okay, and then we got a letter that it was for $2.
Yes. Okay, so here's a letter about that. Hello, Dick and Chad. I watched the episode where Alexis talked about getting the Bluetooth watch for $2. Turns out that seller is a scammer. I purchased 5 watches. I was informed in 5 minutes that my watches had shipped. They sent me a tracking number. Sound too good to be true? It was. The tracking number was bogus. The watches never arrived. Here's a link to the seller's profile page. As you can see, people are not pleased with him. Now, can you bring that up? Because I believe...
Oh, my gosh. Negative. 99% is negative.
I know, but how could this stay on Amazon? That's what he said. Most people said they got phony tracking numbers. They never received the product. Amazon did refund my money, but I thought you would like to have this update on these watches.
Oh,
keep up the good
gosh.
Work. I love the show. Dave Martell. So those watches for $2. But the thing is, he still has a page, right?
I guess. Now, luckily, if you go to his storefront, he's not selling anything. Yeah. It looks like they've taken down anything that they may have been selling, so they're not going to get any new orders. But still, today is August 25th. There's a review from there's multiple reviews from today. These are the first page is all just from today.
This guy must have taken in a bundle of cash.
This is 143 ratings. Oh my gosh. That, and you know, I mean, not everyone's gonna rate. There must be at least 1,000 people that this guy hit, probably.
Yes, yes. And people probably bought multiples, not just, you know, everybody. It's so funny.
It takes until the third page to get a review from yesterday. The third page.
Wow. I love his lifetime rating of positive is 1%.
And I think that's because you can't rate 0 stars.
That's right. That's correct.
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Yeah. Yes. As Conky says, so when you buy a smartwatch for $17, you either get a backdoor into your computer or you get ripped off.
Oh my God. We may have to change the crappy corner to be the reputable corner because I buy the most unreputable stuff.
So do I. Only because the most unreputable stuff is the most fun.
Yeah.
But we learned a lot about the watches.
So this is PC Guy sending a how-to geek article about how things, you know, how I got scammed by counterfeiters on Amazon. Here's how to avoid them. Oh, my God. I may need to read this. That is scary. That's actually
it is scary.
Very scary because this looks awfully similar to what I just bought, you know, what I just showed off on this show.
It does. It does. It's almost better to think, oh, I lost $2 and the guy just ripped me off than, oh my gosh, I gave that guy a way to get into my
information. Access to my phone, you know, back door into my phone. That's insane.
I avoid third-party sellers on Amazon, says Eric Duckman. If I can, that's what eBay is for.
Oh,
yeah. Someone else said, I avoid eBay full stop.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
Interesting and a little scary, to be honest.
A little scary, yes.
Because it says, I mean, that article, you know, these $17 watches are the issue. I'm looking right now at delivered. The price that I paid was $16.99. My phone's been hacked.
That could be. It could be.
Could be. Okay, well, good letters. Thanks for sending in that information.
Yes,
now everyone
thank you,
who watches the Giz Wiz is informed. And I think I'm going to be shopping a lot smarter from now on.
Yeah, and I'm not giving smartwatches for Christmas as I had planned.
No. Gosh darn it, these hackers, they ruined everything.
Yeah.
Okay, well, great, great, great letter. You know what else was great? Meeting fantastic people in person. That's right, we are doing a Giz Wiz meetup. This year, it is on the 2nd of October at the Boat Basin Cafe.
I did update my website, so you can go there.
So go to gizwiz.biz and then click on Dick's Login Blog. It's right there at the top. And you'll see some info about the 6th annual Giz Wiz meetup at the Boat Basin Cafe. And I'll be there. I'm flying in. I won't miss it for the world. And you can find out a little bit of information.
Mysterious producer Josh is coming in for it.
Hasn't been seen in over a year. He's going to be making an appearance.
Wearing his watch that we gave him for his anniversary.
So we can track him. Make sure we don't lose him. From 2 to 4 p.m. And then you can head, of course, to BoatBasinCafe.com. to find out more. It is a perfect venue. We get this great gazebo. You can go get food or drinks. It's right there on the Hudson. You can see Dick's boat from the shore. I mean, it's just fantastic. It's really great.
I always buy the first $100 worth of beer. So
perfect. You should be there. It is on the 2nd of October. I really hope people can make it. It's always a lot of fun. We do games. We give away gadgets. There's beer. There's people. It's a really fun time. So if you can make it, October 2nd, the Boat Basin Cafe from 2 to 4. Of course, that's Eastern time.
Yes.
Make sure that you play What the Heck Is It over at
GizWiz. Yeah, just a few more days.
We will know the next episode what the heck this is. I'm excited because I'm going to be honest. I don't know. I have no clue what this thing is. I'll be honest. It looks like it attaches to a can, like a soda can. And then there's this thing. You know, that's what it's a water, waterfall fountain, you know, you it's upside down and it creates a nice triangular waterfall into your mouth. I don't know what this gadget is. If you do, get on over to gizwiz.biz and make a guess. There's 12 of these Mad Magazines with the poop emoji and all. For correct answers, but 24, double the Mad Magazines for cute, hilarious, ridiculous, clever, and inventive answers for what this gadget is. So get a guessing over at gizwiz.biz. Big thank you, the biggest thank you ever to all of our patrons over at patreon.com. This show is supported independently by you guys. Thank you so much. Patreon.com/GizWiz is where you can go find our page. Patreon is a platform for people to support independent content creators like ourselves. You can see our Patreon page right here. Big thank you to everyone who supports. Even just $1 a show. Fantastic. That is great. If you have enjoyed the GizWiz over the years, please, it would be fantastic if you could throw something, a little something our way.
50 cents a show.
50
what
cents
do I
a
hear?
Show. 25 cents a show. Really, just anything. Thank you guys so much. It's really, really nice of you guys. And you guys, everyone who's supported so far, thank you so much for your generosity in keeping the show afloat. We really do appreciate it. So thank you.
Yeah, we're in year two of independent content.
That is insane. That is insane.
I haven't eaten since January, but we're in year two.
Year two. There you go. Also, don't forget about our show notes. If you want links to everything that we talked about on the show, gizwiz.tv. is the place to go. That is also where you can catch the show live. We record live every Thursday at around 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time. And you can join the chat room. And if you don't catch the show, don't worry. You can subscribe on iTunes or YouTube. We got HD, SD, and audio versions on iTunes. And even while you're there, if for some reason you don't want to support us on Patreon, you can click the Patreon tab, and there's a link there to support us just with a single PayPal donation. That about wraps it up for this episode of The GizWiz. We'll see you next week.
I'll be here.